50 degrees out, so yay, I'm going to can. My neighbor had to go to California to visit her mom, who is not well. So what do you do when you go on a long vacation? You clean out your fridge and your freezer and your garage. So we scored some cuties. Anyway, I got the turkey that she gave me. Actually gave Mom and Nisa, but I'll give Mom and Nisa one from my freezer because I couldn't fit hers in the freezer. So I cooked it, made a big turkey dinner. We're so sick of eating turkey. But it was delicious. I made some turkey stock. No, I didn't. I made turkey broth. When I baked, roasted the turkey, I used salt, pepper, butter, and a mirepoix. And then it's flavored nicely, so I'm going to can it. Clean jars heating up. Turkey broth getting back up to the boil. I have it on medium because I don't want it to scorch. Camp stove board covered with a towel. Funnels, in case I want to use two. Seven rings and jars. Why seven? I don't know. Looks like it might be 5 quarts of broth, but who knows. Being attacked by hummingbirds, they do not want me here. Vinegar and a clean paper towel. Some rings and lids. I'm going to pour a jar of boiling water over them and let them sit here while I'm working. Venting for 7 minutes on the AA, 10 on your Presto. These guys are such moochers. Anyway, I got 6 full quarts and some dregs in that pot. But I think if I had not been impatient and hurting, I would have been able to squeeze 7 quarts out of that, or close to it. I'm trying to learn how to use a stupid cell phone. Check to see how much weight you need for your elevation. For this canner, an all-American canner, at my sea level, it's 10 pounds of pressure. So I'll start timing it when it hits 10 pounds of pressure. Now, if you're using a Presto or anything like that, a dial gauge rather than a weighted gauge, you're going to have to do it like 12 pounds of pressure because it doesn't hold the pressure as well as this. Sorry, I just got buzzed by hummingbirds. I swear we're infested with them. Hungry put that stuff up there that looks like mattress ticking. And they use it to build their little nest with. Those two little beggars. I just went in the house to make tea. And I came out and they thought for some magical reason I'd bring them tons of bread or popcorn or something. But no, not today. I already found bread this morning. And Cheerios too. And start it. There's a large dog who's being walked off leash. And he just chased the rest of the flock of duck birds. He's a girl. She just chased the duck birds. Now these two are terrified because the dog is way over there. And his dad is way over there. And there's no leash in between them. They're ready to fly. I don't know whether I should chase them off or what. 15 more minutes, then I can turn this thing off. They're scared to the waddling. I don't know where the dad is. He's already at his house. And the dog's loose. I don't know. The dog is friendly, but it's a duck chaser. And a goose chaser. And a child chaser. And I don't know why he's doing that without a leash, because the management company does not like that. And since we have an under 10-pound or 20-pound or something limit. That dog's like 5 dogs. They're going to fly, I think, because the dog's going to chase them. Into the pond. All of my appliances are going. However, it's still a vision of yumminess. I want to take Hungry Hubby's stage amps and put them on top of 2 ladders underneath their bedroom and then play something through them, like drums. Very loud drums. Hungry says, no. Return evil for evil to no one. But it's drum music. They like drum music. I don't know. Is that evil?